Welcome to episode 1173, David Packard, Two Men in a Garage. Famous Garage is now registered as the birthplace of Silicon Valley. This picture of David Packard and wife is an outline of episode 1173. David Packard died 25 years ago, but his influence is still felt today in the discovery of the Moderna vaccine.
That I was invited to a conference in Washington, D.C. by the NSF, how to go about actually competing in the world. I happened to sit with somebody at lunch, and that person started telling me how 30 years earlier, he and another colleague of his had started a new company. I had enough courage to ask him who he was, and his name was David Packard from Hewlett-Packard. And I spent another 2 hours asking him as many questions as I could come up with about how one does that. And then I came back to MIT and I literally decided I was going to start a company.
He was born in Pueblo, Colorado in 1912.
At an astonishingly young age, Packard showed his interest in science and electricity, and he shocked his parents and teachers by building his first radio in elementary school.
Packard earned a bachelor and a master's degree in electrical engineering from Stanford University. He met his future wife, Lucille, his future business partner, Bill Hewlett, and Professor Fred Terman, who encouraged him and Bill Hewlett to start a company. Hewlett-Packard was started in 1938 with $538. The name Hewlett-Packard was chosen based on a coin toss. Working around the clock,
Bill had found an apartment down on Addison Avenue, actually still there, with a garage, and so we set up a little shop in this garage, and we'd go to class in the morning, and we'd do some work in the garage, and some of our trying to develop some things for our potential business, time with phone calls and so forth, so he wouldn't get started until maybe the middle of the day, but he worked until 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. And so I would go up there and find out and work until midnight or 1 o'clock.
Their first invention and their first big customer.
Major invention in the winter of 1939 when they created an audio oscillator, which they named the HP-200A.
It was the first big order, and that came from Walt Disney for the movie Fantasia. They needed really good sound.
HP-35 pocket calculator and HP's road to become a global tech giant.
The 35 calculator came out, and I just drooled seeing that thing.
I remember waiting in line to get one of these things. People were selling their cars.
In 1995, he wrote the book, The HP Way. So what is the HP Way?
You also have an obligation to your customers and to your employees and to the community in which you operate.
The best measure of whether we do or do not make a contribution is whether we can market that product at a profit. In other words, whether it's worth more to the customer than it costs us to make.
David Packard died in 1996. He was 83. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and leave your questions and comments below. My next video will be David Packard, 9 Lessons. Wishing everyone peace and prosperity.